Danica here. So in this first video, we are gonna start creating the survey using the JetForm Builder. So our first step here is to create the survey questions. So I generated sample questions here, and the answer options will be this one. And we're gonna divide this into like three categories. And then later, we are gonna get its average. And we also have an overall average. So let's get started. So in your website, you need to have the JetForm Builder installed in order for this to work. And in here, I'm gonna create the form. Okay, so we're just gonna call this survey template A. And here, we're gonna need to add those questions. Okay, so I'm gonna copy this and add some headline first. I'm gonna change. So, headline, heading. And then I'm gonna leave that into H2. And we're gonna add these questions. We're gonna select the radio field in here. Okay, so first we need to add a input label. So I'm gonna paste that question that I have in here. And as you can see, it is capitalized, but you can ignore that because that's just how they formatted it in the front. Once you display this question, it's not gonna look that way. Next is we need to add these options. So we're gonna add this manually. And then we're gonna say label is never. And then value, I'm just gonna put 1. And then calculate is 1. So as you can see, after you add, that's gonna be in here. But we need more, and we're gonna complete these other options. As you can see, you can also clone the existing one and edit from there. If you think that's gonna help you, depending on the type of questions you have. I'm just gonna continue like adding. Hold on. So I have never first, rarely, and then sometimes, and then often. Always. And then update. So if I publish this, and let's try to preview. I'm just gonna add that in this page first so that we can see how it looks while we are building this. So I'm gonna use Elementor. And grab the JetForm. So we're gonna select that survey template A. And I'm just gonna hit the update or save button just to see how this looks. Okay. So this is now our survey questions, and we're gonna style that later. So I'm just gonna finish adding these questions, but the process should be the same. So example, after you completed this, what you can do is you can just click duplicate. And then you can just change the questions and keep the options the way it is because it's just exactly the same. Plus, the value does not change. Okay, so I am now in the second set of questions under learning and growth, and I just pasted an H2, and again, I'm just gonna duplicate the last questions and drag that after the heading and change the questions from that. Okay, so I just completed creating the survey questions with the three categorized sections. So we have self-awareness, learning, and growth. And then we also have personal effectiveness. Next is we are gonna create some breakpoints for each of this. So we only display page 1, page 2, page 3. To do that, we need to grab the form page break. So click the plus button and just type in break. And then there's a form page break. So drag that after the last questions or before the next heading. And click that item. And then on the right, there is an add preview page button. So next and previous is what we want to show. So I'm just gonna duplicate this and drag that again on the, I think I need it here, before the learning growth. And then update. Let's see how this looks. Okay, so we now have the self-awareness on the first page and then the second page. And then the final page. So before I forgot, I'm also gonna make sure these are like required. So make sure whatever questions that like you need to be required answer that they can't skip is you turn that on. So after we save the changes, there should be this asterisk indicator. Now, if you don't like that, of course, we can just remove that via CSS, that character. But that just means these are required. So I can't just skip. I need to like select and then next. If I try to next again, it's not going to allow me to. Okay, so we just finished creating the survey with the three categories in it. Now, we're gonna need to put some value or ID on this category, but I'm gonna show that to you next. So in the next video, we are gonna finish this form and take advantage of the assigned value and calculate the average.